I would love for them to take from the reunion, 50th class reunion, that it hasn't always been this way. That while they don't know what it means to go to a movie and not be able to buy your ticket and sit where everybody's sitting. We had to go on a side door, we went up the steps, and there was a black lady there that sold us our tickets. We had to sit in the balcony. We weren't allowed to sit, like people say. We couldn't use the bathroom. We had to go across the street to the jailhouse and use the bathroom, which was a public bathroom for drunks and everybody else, so you could hardly stand the stench. But that's where you had to go if you needed to use the bathroom. They don't know what it means to get on a train and it's safe for whites only. See, when we got out of high school, one of the girls in there and I went up north, and we had to sit in the black section. So, you know, it might have been integrated, but it wasn't integrated enough to let us sit where we wanted to on the train.
What do you want them to take away from a 50th reunion?
Don't take blessings. Don't take everything you see for granted, because it's been a long struggle. Some people had to die for us to get to do the things that we enjoy, things that they take for granted because they just don't understand. And when you try to tell them, a lot of them say, oh, you're just old fogey, but that's the way it is. That's the way it works. And they just need to know that. We need to tell them. We need to tell them where they came from, where we came from, so they don't think that everything is just handed to them on a plate. Somebody had to pay a great price for the freedoms that we enjoy. And we think back 50 years ago, we've come a mighty long way. Grace of God, we've come a mighty long way.